Hey all, here are OS Reviews. Today we're taking a closer look at a portable monitor from UPerfect. What makes this a little bit different from some of the other portable monitors we've seen in the past, which usually sell for around $200, is this one is using a QLED panel. That's the same technology that Samsung uses on their more expensive, high-definition TVs, and produces more contrasty colors compared to regular LCD or LED displays. It does this through a, as the name implies, quantum dot layer, which is missing on a conventional LED display. It claims to cover 100% of the deep PI P3 color gamut, so this should be a very color accurate display as well. It's also a touchscreen display. It gets up to 500 nits, so very bright. One thing I will say though is if you're not familiar, QLED is still not the same as OLED, which is OLED or AMOLED, like what you'll find from, say, a Samsung smartphone or from LG's high-definition TVs, which can display more inky blacks because when it's showing a dark background, actually no pixels are lit. So it has that slightly more popping nature compared to LED, but QLED is still supposed to be the next generation step up compared to regular LED displays, and we'll see that in terms of, again, the brightness, the color accuracy, things like that. And it also claims to support a unique pressure-sensitive mode. In fact, it claims to support up to 4,000 levels of pressure sensitivity, which means if it's paired with the correct program, you'll be able to draw harder and lighter just by pressing harder or lighter on the screen itself. Now, inside of the packaging, we have quite a few accessories, including a AC adapter, which is using a modern USB Type-C plug. Since, again, this monitor is using QLED, it draws more power than some of the past LED monitors we've seen, so this one here requires up to 18 watts for it to supply enough juice to it, and also a few sets of additional cables which are included, including a Type-C to Type-C, both for video as well as for charging. Here's another Type-C cable, in fact, you get two of those in the box, and here we have a Type-C to Type-A, in addition to a HDMI cable, a mini HDMI to full-sized HDMI. So it probably means there isn't a standard port, but you need to use this little adapter here. And by the way, the display itself has a 1080p, so full HD resolution. Although technically there are some 4K monitors now on the market, to be completely honest, I think that's overkill on something that has a portable size like this, because in order to use a 4K monitor, you have to really be sure that you'll be consuming 4K media, which is not the case for the majority of folks out there. Oftentimes, if you're just watching back a video, or if you're just doing some office work, 1080p is still kind of the full resolution that you'll be getting from most laptops and devices that you link it up to. So really good enough, and also drawing less power. It also helps keep the costs a bit lower since this model is selling for around $300 or so, which I think is still very reasonable for something that's using the newer QLED standard, so brighter, more vivid, in addition to having all those features like pressure sensitivity, touch control. Anyways, in terms of the monitor itself, although the box is a little bit generic in its presentation, the monitor is very nicely presented. We have a magnetic folio case that will become the kickstand once you pop it up, and the magnets here are dual-sided, since as aforementioned, the surface on the top here is made out of glass, but the same thing goes for the back of the monitor, can also be peeled off from the cover here. So you can see this is the back of the monitor. It's very attractive looking, but the slight downside would be, of course, glass is a bit more fragile and it will attract fingerprints more easily. However, it's definitely a very sleek design, almost something that Samsung maybe would have used on a Galaxy device. As aforementioned, the rails of the tablet are constructed out of aluminum, so it does still feel super sturdy. On the right-hand edge, we have access to a 3.5mm headphone jack. There's also a switch that you can tap on to control and navigate the menu interface. You'll find one of the stereo speakers and then another one on the other side, along with the connection ports, including the aforementioned mini HDMI and two USB Type-C ports. So in total, we have three connections on here, but again, it would have been nice maybe to have a full-size HDMI, very similar to other portable 15.6-inch monitors we've seen in the past in terms of their thickness, even though we have added functionality here of touch, pressure sensitivity, and new display technology. So overall, a pretty thin profile that you'll find. As far as the ergonomics of the kickstand, basically you open it up. By the way, the inside here is a soft touch microfiber, so it cleans the display and prevents it from getting scratched up. It's essentially creating a lip here that the tablet can then be popped open at without sliding around. So after you put it up like this, it's not going to move anywhere. And if you're on a flat surface, you can also move it a little bit further back if you want to, have a slight adjustment in terms of angle there, but not a ton if you're comparing it with, say, a Surface tablet. A few observations here, one of them being that the monitor doesn't come with a pre-applied screen protector, so we just have the tempered glass screen on the front here, which is already pretty good in terms of scratch resistance, but it would have been nice to maybe have a film included. It is what it is. It's very sleek and smooth to the touch, although it is a little bit attractive to fingerprints. Alright, so in this first demo, we have it just connected to a Samsung Galaxy device, and when you're connected using Type-C, it goes into this DeX mode or desktop mode, and it works quite well in terms of touch. Everything is fully functional, as you can see there. We can interact with the display. It feels very fluid. Your phone's power will likely not be sufficient to power the display completely, and that's why oftentimes you still need to use the other Type-C port to connect to a power bank or to the wall for it to still turn on. Let's say we open up the multi-touch tester app here. We can verify the 10 fingers of multi-touch just by putting our hands here, and you can see 10 is being registered, so that's working as advertised. Now we can tap on the jog dial on the side here, basically up and down to change the volume for the built-in speakers. I can also do something like tap inwards, essentially to bring up the additional menus. And what's neat here is that you can control this directly using touch. So the menu here can be interacted with your fingers. It's actually pretty similar in terms of the design language to what Samsung already has on their skins. So it looks pretty cohesive, and it's a difference compared to some older portable monitors we've seen, which had more of a primitive interface for controlling these settings. It required you to use the side keys to go up, down, left, and right instead of responding to touch directly. So this is pretty intuitive, easy to use. So we can take a look at things like HDR here is on auto mode. We can turn it on if we want to, and that will just make the colors more punchy. As you can see there, it loses a bit of accuracy, but does make things pop a bit more. And also changing things like the system language can also be changed. Tweaking some other things here, you can also do things like change the color temperature yourself to make the display more blue if you want to. You can also make it more green in color, more red, so you can adjust these properties yourself, or use one of the presets that will automatically kind of adjust things to a color temperature, or save kind of your user profile. You can also go into a few different modes, such as for playing back video. It's going to be in an eco mode, so it's going to optimize the brightness as well as the contrast. Gaming mode here will be a little bit brighter and change the color temperature ever so slightly. Viewing back text, you can see how the display here is now kind of a more yellowish, purplish tint, so it's easier on your eyes when you're reading. There's also kind of a high FPS mode, so if you're doing gaming, you want higher frame rates, this is going to be the mode, although the maximum refresh rate of the display is still 60 Hz, so it doesn't have, say, 90 or 120 Hz like on smartphone screens, but that's pretty much as expected these days on portable monitors. That's still the case on most models we've seen. It is getting almost a OLED or AMOLED-like nature to it in terms of its vibe and reproduction. It's just when it's displaying a black background, it still is technically having pixels turned on, even though it's better than traditional LCD or LED, so it's not quite as energy efficient as OLED when it's showing something completely dark, but it gets close enough in terms of the actual experience, giving us sufficient details on a screen of this size. Some images here, again filled with detail, very beautiful to use. Pinch and zoom gestures are natural and work very well. Again, the bezel size on the tablet is also quite slim in terms of the left, right, and top. The bottom does have a slight chin, but overall not too bad. Still is a very immersive screen, I think, for interacting with media. It definitely isn't going to distract you from enjoying the content that you're looking at. So as aforementioned on Windows, using just one Type-C port connected to your laptop is sufficient for drawing the power needed to also turn on the display. One thing I will say though is that the pressure sensitivity, the claimed 4000 levels, is a little bit tricky to find applications which are compatible for it, as well as devices which work for it out of the box. And that's because, again, as you notice in the unboxing, there isn't really a pen that they bundle with you along with the monitor. Since this really isn't a replacement for a drawing tablet or a Wacom tablet, at least that's something that the manufacturer claims, it's just a bonus secondary feature. That's because if you have some existing touch-sensitive pens on your tablets or computers, for example, Wacom styluses will not work, since as expected, it doesn't have kind of a Wacom digitizer electromagnetic layer inside, so it isn't using this type of technology. And then also if you're using Intrig pens, it also doesn't seem to be really compatible. So a lot of these active styluses, which have for example, battery inside, or it's using Wacom technology, is not going to be compatible with the pressure sensitivity that this particular monitor offers. Of course, it's going to work with any passive or kind of dumb stylus that conducts your touch, and that just kind of works like your finger does. So what I think the levels of pressure sensitivity are is it's built into the display based on how hard you're pressing. So technically, it's very similar to 3D force touch, like on iPhones back in the day. However, programs which support this type of pressure sensitivity are still pretty rare, and you have to get into more professional tools to kind of dig it up and go into more advanced settings. A lot of the applications which typically support inking, such as the Paint 3D app or Windows Journal apps, typically don't allow you to have pressure sensitivity, so even as I'm pressing harder and lighter, it doesn't really necessarily respond. Still, the touchscreen itself is pretty responsive, even if you're using just your fingers or just a dumb stylus. Most of the time, it will still pick up what you're trying to do, and you'll be able to do some quick sketching and note-taking really without too many problems here. But again, if you're trying to get this exclusively for artwork and you want the pressure sensitivity to work out of the box with every single application, that's probably not going to be the case here. You do have to really find some edge cases where it works, and hopefully we'll be seeing more support down the line. So let's do a quick demo of watching back a video clip and trying out the speakers next. Takeaways from that demo, again, the viewing angles are indeed very wide and generous. The speakers is also not shabby for something that's pretty small and slim. It's not going to rival a dedicated Bluetooth speaker in terms of lacking a bit in terms of bass, but in terms of trebles, it does sound quite clean, doesn't really distort even at higher volumes. So better than, I would say, standard smartphone speakers because it is a stereo pair and does pack a decent amount of volume. And of course, also for gaming, for sports, if you want to connect it to a Switch, a retro emulator, it's going to be very enjoyable when it comes to giving you just a beautiful display with great colors and reproduction for enjoying yourself when you're on the go, easy to take with you and travel with. Although, of course, again, it doesn't have perhaps the lowest refresh rate. Latency is still already very low thanks to the direct connection using Type-C or HDMI, so no real complaints. So overall, again, working quite well. Also, again, for work productivity, it's just a great all-rounder display, I think, with a good resolution when it comes to the sharpness, definitely improved color accuracy as well as vibrancy because of the QLED nature compared to regular LED and LCD screens, but you don't want to shell out an arm or a leg for a 4K panel or something that has a true OLED or AMOLED display, which will typically sell you for a few hundred bucks more. So you can learn more details if you're interested, but for now that's been our video. Thanks for watching here at OS Reviews. That's been the YouPerfect 15.6-inch QLED touchscreen monitor.